Hello, and welcome to another episode of 5 Minutes with Franza. I'm your host, Dr. Thomas Franza. In this episode, I'm going to show you how to install Solver Table. I'll be using Windows 7 as my operating system, and I'm using Excel 2010. However, it's very similar, and I'll point out the differences if you were using another version of Windows or a different version of Excel. It should be noted, if you're doing Solver Table for something prior to Excel 2007, you need a separate file. Regardless, you'll get these files from either your professor or your college or university. With that,
okay,
let's begin. The first thing we're going to need is to have downloaded a Solver Table. I've already done that just for the sake of brevity. Okay, I downloaded it, and you'll see it is a zipped file, which is usual when you're downloading something off the internet. And I double-click in there, and there is the XLSM. This is a file we're going to need. Okay, there are even directions to tell you how to use it. However, I found that sometimes they don't exactly work, so I'm going to show you another way to do it as well. Okay, so we're going to need this file. So what we do is going to move this over here. Now, what they claim is you can simply open up Excel, open up this file, and Solver Table will work for the duration of your Excel session. If it does, beautiful, great, move on. However, if it doesn't, watch what we need to do. What we need to do is we need to go to My Computer, and we have to actually navigate to where Excel, the add-ins are kept. So that's on our local disk. You may need elevated permissions to do this. So if it balks or if this is an Office PC, you may have to call the help desk and have them assist you. Double-click on Program Files, x86, and we're going to scroll down until we see Microsoft Office. Double-click on that. Office 14, because I'm using Excel 2010. If it was a prior version, this number would be less, like Office 13 and so on. Double-click on Office 14. Now, you would think you would go to the Add-ins folder. You don't. You go to the folder called Library. Double-click on that. See where Solver is? Double-click again. This is where the Solver Table XLSM needs to be. So you would take this and copy it here. I'm going to digress for a moment. Suppose you might get lucky enough to actually have this XLAM file, depending on who you're getting the file from. If you do, simply copy this here. That'll make your life so much easier. But we're going to make life difficult for ourselves because we're going to pretend we didn't have access to that. Okay. I take this, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to right-click, drag it here, and say copy here. Are you sure? And you see you need administrative rights? You say yes, and continue. Now that it's here, it's like any other add-in. So let's minimize these two screens. Now we start Excel. Now that Excel starts up, File. This was Office 2007. I'd have the little circly thing. I then go to my Options, Add-ins, Go, and now there's Solver Table 2007. I say OK. What's going to happen is you can see right where it says View, another little tab is going to make itself available. You say OK. Enable macros. Yes, Solver Table 2007/2010 is a macro. If you do not enable macros, it will not work. Boom. Add-ins. There it is. Okay. Let's. When you exit out, this tab should always be there. If it isn't, all you simply have to do is go back to File, Options, Add-ins. Sometimes it needs to be tickled. You say Go. And if it's checked, uncheck it, say OK, then go back and re-edit it again and it'll appear. That's all there is to it. Let's go over how you copy the file because that's where most students have the most problems. So let's close it out. And okay, I have my Solver Table XLSM file, or the XLAM if we're lucky. Double-click on My Computer. C. Program Files x86. If this was prior to Windows 7, it would just be Program Files. Okay, you wouldn't have this extra option. I scroll down until I find Microsoft Office. I double-click. I find Office 14. If this was a previous version of Office, this would be Office 13, 12, 11. You get the concept. Okay, again, it is not add-ins. We go to Library, Solver, and copy this here. Once we're done, now we can add it like any other add-in. I will create another video to show you how to use SolverTable and how if SolverTable isn't working, you can even get around that too. But that is how you install SolverTable. I hope you found this episode of 5 Minutes with Franza useful. If you'll be using SolverTable, I know you'll find it useful. Once again, thank you for watching. I am your host, Dr. Thomas Franza.